Hello and welcome back. Happy to see you again. This is my first video in 2022 and I want to talk about Grasshopper how to install Grasshopper plugins the cleanest possible way, at least for me the cleanest possible way, the most logic way for me, and a way where I have the most control and overview over my files on my computer. I really don't like it when I install software and I don't know at the end where they live on my computer and where they're hiding, in which folder. And I understand that Grasshopper tried to make it very convenient in the past to allow people to just take the component and drop it onto the Grasshopper window. And that worked fine for certain, and it still works fine for certain components, especially when they're smaller. But first of all, it does not work always. Second, you don't know where the file is installed. And third, if you want to change something or you want to uninstall it, you don't even know where to look for. And especially then when these components are bigger and have more files involved, and then you use that method, it can happen that not everything gets installed which is needed, and then plugins maybe appear but they actually don't work properly and create bugs and mistakes, and people get frustrated and so on. There are a lot of components which are actually well documented and they have a very good description on how to install it, and then there are others, they have even their own installation file which does everything automatically. But yeah, I think it's good to know where the things are installed, and I had certainly some issues in the past where I just didn't understand how these files are installed and where they are, and this created a lot of questions and confusions and issues where I had to uninstall stuff and reinstall, and that was not fun and took quite a lot of time to look into forums and online descriptions and how it works. And I think it could be avoided really by explaining it better. I'm not alone with these problems. There are other people who have similar issues, and I know that, and I can see that from my comments and people writing me and asking me, and they come with these issues, and I just immediately know, okay, the installation was the problem. That's why this video, caveat, this is not, this will not work for every installation, because it's not just about the installation, it's also about your Rhino version, your Grasshopper version, the version of the component you want to install. They need to work together. And very often plugins actually need to access software outside of Rhino on your computer to run. Like for example, Honeybee relies heavily on external software, or like on software which is runs on your computer but not within Rhino. So, and that component need to be also the right version to fit to your Honeybee and so on. So this is just a general suggestion and a method you could try if you run into issues. And I think it's in general good practice to know where the things are on your computer. Okay, I will use Octopus as an example. So I haven't installed it yet. I used this example because somebody came to me and asked and had exactly these issues where the person just dropped the file onto the Grasshopper canvas and it appeared here, but then not all the components worked correctly. So now we are here in Rhino and Grasshopper, and before we download the component, I actually want to show you where the files are stored. So if you go on files and you go into special folders, you can actually see that there are four subfolders: the component folder, settings folder, user objects folder, and autosave folder. If we go here, then the Windows Explorer opens and actually points to your folder on your computer, and here it's actually named a bit different. If you just go on Grasshopper, then this is your settings folder, and then you have the libraries, which is the component folder. This is where we install stuff, and then we have the user objects. Sometimes things are also installed here, for example here butterflies installed here. I recommend to install stuff here on libraries, except the component has its own installation method and installation executable file, then yeah, just let it do what it does. Now, in order to install stuff, we can go to Food for Rhino. This is a repository of, I would say, the largest repository for Grasshopper plugins, Rhino plugins, and Grasshopper plugins. In order to download stuff, you need to create a user, but this is free, and then you can download components. And I want to use Octopus as a as an example because recently I had somebody who had the issue with the Octopus installation, and I think it's a good example. So Octopus is a evolutionary solver similar to Galapagos. I will not go further into detail on what it does. We can do it another time, but I will use it as this for this example. So if we go here, you have the download button. If you're not logged in, then it would say log in. Download actually brings you to this portion here, which are all the different versions of the plugin. And if you look here, there's actually no description on how to install it. Well, actually there is, but it's very hidden. It's actually here. For instruction on installing Grasshopper add-ons, please see this link. Very useful. And you can have a look at that later on. It will be basically the same what I'm gonna tell you, with the only difference that I will say something and this video just shows things. Okay, we can download here. Goes It's downloading here. I will bring it to my folder where I normally save all my apps. And yeah, you can see here I downloaded and saved it here, Octopus zip file. And then you just need to extract everything. So you get this file here, this folder here. And in this folder, it's another folder with the same name, 0.4. And here are all the files needed or to run Octopus. At the moment it's not installed, so in order to install, I would not recommend to just grab it. You know, people do this and add it. I will not do that. I'll actually take the whole folder, copy, and go into my components folder and then place it here. Now, very important, what you need to do now is go here in the Grasshopper assembly file, which is the GHA with the ending GHA, you right click and you go on properties. And in here, and this is crucial for a security reason, this component is blocked at the moment. So you need to unblock. You can do this here. If you don't see this, then don't worry because then it's already unblocked. I guess it depends on your Windows version or computer. Or user rights, maybe, I don't know. But this is a crucial step for me, otherwise this component will not run or it will create issues. And then you just apply, then it's gone. So if that looks like this for you in the first place, then it's already, then no problem. Now I can restart. And now I can restart Rhino. Now launch Grasshopper. And I have Octopus installed. And if you want to uninstall it, go back here and just close Rhino and Grasshopper because at the moment it's loaded in your in the program, and just close, and then you can delete this here, and that means it's basically uninstalled. Yeah, I hope that helps, and yeah, happy scripting. See you in the next video.